I am Aparna, belonging to the Department of English. My topic is Magic Realism in Ben Oakley's The Famished Children. Literature represents life. To represent life, it cannot be the realistic account. If it is a complete realistic account, it becomes a history. Writers, from time immemorial, have been producing works combining real and unreal elements. This is the exact definition of literature, and this is what magic realism is. In 1925, Franz Rowe used this term, magic realism, to define post-expressionist paintings. In 1927, Massimo Bontempelli used this term to refer to the novels with various features which can be called modern novels. Magic realism became a concept in Latin America when Garcia Marquez published his 100 Years of Solitude. Later, this boom became widespread and it became a tool in the hands of the writers all over the world. Magic realism can be defined. Magic realism is a narrative, which means a spoken or real written account of connected events. It is an oxymoron. Contradictory terms appear in conjunction, that is, magic and real. Both are contradictory. They are brought together and it is magic realism. Magic realism is the extraordinary way of looking at ordinary elements. Magical elements are blended into realistic setting for an in-depth understanding of reality. They blend in such a way that at one point they become inseparable. Magic realism is in everyday setting, it is invaded by strangeness. What is real? That which is not imaginary, that which is verifiable, that which is taken from the real life, which is mimetic, logical, empirical, that which is existent. Gordon, here, there, Texas, India, New Delhi are examples of real life. The house was burgled. The police arrested the thief. This is an example of real account. What is magical? Magical is unreal, imaginary, non-existent, fictitious, fabulous, dream. The examples of magical elements in literature are witches, demons, hell, heaven, evils, etc. The play Macbeth begins with the three witches scene. Macbeth's overambitious nature, his plan to kill their Duncan, all these are considered to be real. So these realistic elements come out of the unrealistic event, that is the witches scene. The employment of supernatural and natural in a proper rhythm has brought Shakespeare a universal acclaim. What is the purpose of magic? To emphasize on the real, to entertain the readers, to enliven the real, and to kill the monotonous account of real life. It cannot diminish the importance of real. Aristotle, in his Poetics, stresses on this intangible element in a work of art. Source of magic. Magic comes from oral literature, which means human communication wherein culture, knowledge, ideas are transmitted from one generation to the other. Myth, an ancient story with gods and demigods. Legends, stories that is about great heroes and their achievements. Folk tales, sayings, music, dance, preserved among a group of people to bring meaning to their life. Fables. A fictional story in prose or verse form featuring animals, legendary creatures, inanimate objects, etc. Characteristics of magic realism. Hybridity is an important characteristic feature of magic realism. Hybridity can be defined as a fact, if fact and fiction, rural and urban, ancient and the modern, western and the indigenous, or brought together in magical realism without any line of demarcation between them. It has binary nature, irreconcilable elements or fear forcibly kept together in a magical realist text. Magical realism has a sense of mystery throughout. Mysterious elements pervade throughout the text and create horror and surprise, making the atmosphere eerie for the readers. Fantastical elements plays a major role in a magical realist text. Fabulous and fantasy elements are added and presented in a realistic and irreducible way. They become concrete and they cannot be separated from the real. Incredible descriptions. The descriptions that are found in magical realism text, for example, witches, evils, heaven, hell, spirit world, Hercules, all these are new, unheard of, strange to the readers. So, the writer tries to give a mind map, mind picture to the readers by his description. His descriptions are incredible, like the worlds, but it enables the reader to enter into a different imagination. Political critique. Magical realist texts are political critiques because the contemporary political environment is disheartening. So the writers resort to magical realism to hide their anger. Magical realist texts are also called subversive texts and revolutionary texts. Ben Okri, he is a Nigerian. He was born on 15th March 1959 in Minna during the euphoria of Nigerian independence, which had transformed into despondency. His father is Silver Okri in Yoruba and his mother is Grace Okri. Okri is placed with Salman Rushdie, Isabel Allende and Gorgia Mackus in the literary arena. Ben Okri's works, his fictions are Flowers and Shadows, The Landscapes Within, Dangerous Love, The Famished Road, Songs of Enchantment, Infinite Riches, In Arcadia, Star Book, and he has also written poetry, Mental Flight and African Energy. About his works, critics categorize his works as post-colonial, post-modern, transcultural narrative, magical reality, fantasy and ecocentric. Basis of magic realism in Okri. Okri had a strong ethnic background. It was provided by the stories narrated by his Igbo mother, and he was brought up in the tradition of Yoruba by his father. It gave him ethnic background. He dwelt on African culture and tradition for the magical elements. Black consciousness in London. Okri, during his stay in London in his early life, he underwent racial discrimination among the whites in his primary education. It left an indelible mark in young Okri. Pre-colonial Nigeria. The Nigerian land was a land of peace and there was no clash among people during the pre-colonial period. had turned into a land of cultural degradation and land of slavery during colonialism, and later into a land of bloodshed because of civil war and the political anarchy in Nigeria. The hyphenated identity of Okri contributed much to rely upon magical realism. Okri's hyphenated identity. Okri moved to London for primary education, and he moved back to Mina, where his father, as a lawyer, moved with downtrodden sufferers. Then he moved to London for his studies with a scholarship given by Nigerian government. But his scholarship was stopped, and Okri was pushed to the streets with a handful of literary texts. The Famished Row, it is a trilogy. The other works being Songs of Enchantment and Infinite Riches. It is a voluminous work for about 500 pages. It is a Booker Prize winning novel. It got the Booker Prize in the year 1991. It had got the Yoruban concept. Here Okri shows the Nigerian landscape, the forest, marketplace and the slum of Lagos. Fantasy and reality mixed together, and fantasy serves as a standard realm to make the readers understand the polluted contemporary environment of Nigeria. Okri's Nigeria shown in the Famished Road. From his homeland, London, Okri sees his native land, Nigeria, sets his words there. The ghetto dwellers and the downtrodden sufferers of fractured Nigeria is presented by Okri. His life in Ajegunle slum brought him the first-hand knowledge of the living conditions of urban poor. Biafran war has made him an endless miner into the human spirit. Concept of hybridity in the Famished Row, spirit world, supernatural world and the Nigerian world. Azaro is portrayed both as a human child as the Nabiku. Madame Porto comes as a colossal figure and as a woman with mysterious powers. Madame Porto's bar is found in real life and also in the unreal setting. There are speaking animals also. So this is by it has got binary nature without any line of boundary. Fantastical elements. There are worlds within worlds, ghost world, supernatural world and Nigerian world. Spirits, herbalists, wizards, demon are there, and they become concrete and the fantasy become irreducible in Famished Road. Incredible description. The worlds presented by Okri are strange. So, Okri presents all those worlds with his description. So, this incredible description gives life to his work. Political critique. The politicians and their trick, the milk distribution, the thugs, they occupy the premier position in the Famished Road, and the real account of the post-colonial world is found in the Famished Road. Sense of mystery hovers around the work. It has got every atmosphere. There are strange animals, Madame Porto, all these give a mysterious atmosphere to his work. There is distortion of time and space, confusing time shifts. There is no logic of time passage. The characters travel between real world and unreal, past and future, real, spirit world and earth. All the actions are intermingled. Many actions take place in the same time at different places. Thank you.